Pregame Live, presented by Fields Auto Group.
A gorgeous day for baseball here at the friendly confines of beautiful Wrigley Field. This place will shoehorn in almost 42,000. Cubs look to get back to their winning ways as they battle the Rockies with their ace Jake Arrieta on the hill. And welcome in to our Fields Auto Group Cubs Pregame Live. He's Todd Hollinsworth. I'm David Kaplan. Joe Maddon said yesterday and again this morning, just flush yesterday's game. Bad day all around. It happened.
Well, it's an easy game to flush because a lot went wrong. Offense didn't do too much yesterday. Let me say this. I thought Kyle Hendricks was outstanding yesterday. He actually made a lot of pitches. Defense let him down. Compounded the problems. It's a game that got away from them, but it's an easy game to flush, Cap. As we talked about yesterday, when there's a lot of bad, everybody knows about it. Everybody wants to get rid of it.
Let's talk about the miscues from yesterday. They're physical errors, not mental, and those things are going to happen because it's an imperfect game played by human beings.
Absolutely, and it's kind of what you saw yesterday. Some in-between hops, guys that got the ball, some errant throws, some throws that got rushed. Just a culmination of things. The ball just didn't want to stay, seemed to want to stay in the glove, and when it did, some of the throws were hurried as well. So it was a combination of things. We did see a lot of action on the ground yesterday, but a game to forget altogether.
It's also a team where, okay, we had a bad day. We got our ace on the hill today. Just flush it and let's come ready to play today.
Well, it's the best answer that you have is that you got Jake Arrieta going today, and certainly you should be, as we all are, excited to see him make his Wrigley Field debut today. But with that being said, Arrieta's been locked in. He's been pitching great at home as he did last year. Certainly expecting big things from him today.
And how about the crowd and the weather? I mean, this is what you expect.
Yeah, this is best day of the year. I'm just going to go ahead and say it. If you're not down here, it's your fault. It's 72 degrees. It's gorgeous. And we got Jake Arrieta on the mound.
It should be a lot of fun. All right, third member of our team, as always, is Kelly Kroll. And she checks in with this pregame report brought to you by Coors.
Thanks a lot. Well, speaking of Wrigley Field debuts, we're going to get our first look at Javier Baez this afternoon here at Wrigley, getting the start at second. Joe Maddon, of course, wanted to get him out there as soon as possible following his rehab stint. And it really made sense with Christian Bergman on the mound today for the Rockies, a reverse split type guy. So you're going to see a righty-heavy lineup. Also, Matt Caesar, Jorge Soler out there, Jason Hayward, and Ben Zobrist getting the afternoons off. But Maddon, of course, the big challenge for him this year is consistent playing time for these guys and consistent at-bats, and he explained before the game what his ideal situation for Javier Baez would be moving forward.
Like you're seeing right now, giving Zobrist a day off, he'll give Addison a day off. In the outfield, there's really not a need to have him give somebody a day off there unless something were to be dramatically wrong. Game in progress, though, there's a lot of things you can do with him, whether it's as a pinch hitter or defense, late inning defensive replacement, too. I'll just try to be creative, like I said. Really watch it. Just try to keep your finger on the pulse of the entire situation. Right now, you know, you probably can see where you could possibly get him two or three starts a week right now, which may be about, you know, the maximum way to do it as of right now. And then you just hopefully everybody stays healthy and it continues to be a problem to get him in the game.
With the team that we have, we're going to be rotating a lot, but. Yeah, for sure. I'm a player to be on the field every day. This is a game that it's about making adjustment, and this last couple years it's been up and down, like you say, and hopefully this year with everything that I learned, I get everything together and have a good year.
Bryant, who's hitting third today, approaching his one-year anniversary of being in the bigs. It's hard to believe that as of tomorrow, last season's Rookie of the Year was making his debut, an 0-for-4 outing with 3 Ks. But of course, we all witnessed the talent over the last year, watching him develop into the all-star player that he is now. And KB, having a little fun with the thought of his one-year mark in the show.
At times it feels longer, at times it feels a lot shorter. I guess it feels shorter when you're having fun because time's flying by, but yeah, I mean, I just looked at my phone the other in there and I was talking to Lackey. I was like, 2 days we're going to have a party. It's going to be my year birthday or whatever, but it's been a good year for me. I learned a lot along the way, and I'm far from where I want to be, but I can look back and be pleased with what has happened to me.
Putting that party room in the new clubhouse to good use here early on, Chris Bryant saying he might end up in the middle of that dance party very soon, Cap. But certainly it's hard to believe that he's already been up here for a year and couldn't have imagined in a million years, he said, seeing himself on billboards for clothing endorsements of all things. So certainly, getting to grow up with the other young guys who are getting those kinds of endorsements as well. And Jake Arrieta on the mound today, of course, one of them.
Kelly, thanks very much. Kelly will be, of course, reporting in-game, and you'll see her on the post-game as well as the Cubs and the Rockies play game two of this three-game set. Time now for a brand-new feature. We started it yesterday here on the pregame. Check it out. It's a brand-new feature that we want you to get interactive with. It's the CSNChicago.com fan vote. Here's how you get involved. Go to our webpage, CSNChicago.com/vote. Today's question, who would you like to see get the majority of the starts in left field? Holly, how would you vote?
Well, I think right now, unless you're going to tell me you're planning on trading for Nolan Arenado and Chris Bryant might end up out there, my answer is going to be Jorge Soler. Real good opportunity for him today. You'll see when we put up the lineups, he's smack dab in the middle of the lineup, and he gets the start out in left field. So I'm thrilled for him. I want to see him capitalize on this. I go back a couple years when he just kind of played great, did everything really, really well. Last year, a bit of a down year. Good opportunity for him.
Yeah, you know, another guy who's going to get an opportunity today, he's playing right, but also fits in that mix in left, is Matt Caesar, who's been off to a nice start. And I know the first week, everyone thought, well, he'll be going back down. And then Baez took one off the head, had the thumb injury, and then Schwarber goes down. You never know what break comes your way.
I like a little thunder and lightning, and I think that's what Caesar certainly brings to this team. I love it, and it's been good to see so far. He's earning more playing time.
All right, our instant poll winner goes to Jorge Soler, 33% of the vote. Thank you very much. We'll have another one of these poll questions for you where you can see the results right there on your screen, your tablet, your mobile. You don't have to register. We'd love for you to participate with us all season long. Jorge Soler will be in the lineup. Our bar of the game today, today's CSN bar of the game presented by Coors Light, is Timothy O'Toole's Pub. If you're not heading to Wrigley, watch today's CSN broadcast at Timothy O'Toole's. To simply see the complete list of the CSN bars of the game presented by Coors Light, visit CSNChicago.com. All right, time to look at today's pitching matchup. It's brought to you by the original beef. That's Bona Beef. Cubs send their ace, his name is Jake Arrieta, against Christian Burks.
Well, listen.
Bona's really good.
Yeah, I guess so. You've convinced me, no doubt about it. Jake Arrieta, listen, he's our ace. We know what he's got. He's been fantastic this year keeping the ball on the ground. Certainly that's what I picked up on the last two starts. When there is contact, 62% of the time it's been on the ground. You're going to see him attack this lineup. One thing that you have to keep in the back of your mind, Cargo, Arenado, the guys in the middle, these guys can play. They're good hitters. They're good hitters at Coors Field. They're good hitters away from Coors Field. They both have power. But again, very favorable matchup today. Bergman making his first start of the season.
He only started four games a year ago. This is considered a spot start. The young right-hander that the Cubs had considered drafting the year they took Chris Bryant, Jonathan Gray, is dealing with an ab injury.
Right.
So they're going to give Bergman this start. His first appearance, he did not pitch well. His second appearance,
better.
He did pitch much better. But in terms of being a starter, he's being put in a really, really tough spot.
Well, certainly. I mean, if you want to look at it as far as the pitching matchups are concerned, going up against the National League's best in Jake Arrieta, you're right. It's lopsided. I mean, this is a young man who's kind of a grinder. His stuff isn't great. Doesn't strike out a lot of guys, doesn't walk a lot of guys. So this is a real good opportunity for the Cubs offense to do some damage and get back on track based on what we saw yesterday.
Check out Bergman's splits against righties and lefties in his career. Right-handers are absolutely killing him with a .362 average, an OPS of .997. He's allowed 15 homers to righties as opposed to just two for lefties. So Joe Maddon was talking with us this morning about 10 o'clock. He said, look, I've had reverse split guys where it's so predominant one way, like this guy, where righties kill him and lefties don't do anywhere near as well. And he said, I actually told Ben Zobrist and Fernando Perez down in Tampa,
right,
I want you guys to hit righty against the righty. I don't want you to hit lefty. And they both agreed. He said, Perez got a hit the first time up. Went, this is awesome. He said, Zobrist popped up and goes, I'm not doing that again. He said, stick with it. He said he ended up getting a double and a single righty on righty. So I asked Dexter Fowler. He said, Joe has told me, why don't you think about hitting righty today? He said,
no shot.
Yeah, well, you know, that's tough for guys to do. The only time in my career that I even saw it was knuckleballers, because a lot of times guys wanted to see it from the same side. That would be the one instance, or the case where guys are just flat out giving up on being switch hitters and they're just going to become all right-handed or all right or left-handed. But very rarely do you see it. I love the thought. I love the concept. But again, getting a guy to change like Dexter Fowler right now, I'm not sure is the right thing to do. He's locked in on both sides of the plate. He's putting together great at-bats. He's used to seeing the arm slot, righty-lefty, lefty-righty, and I wouldn't mess with it right now.
He's playing with exceptionally well. We've got to take our first time out here at our Fields Auto Group Cubs pregame live. It's Jake Arrieta on the bump, a packed house, gorgeous weather. That should be, hopefully, a really good recipe for Cubs fans to celebrate today. We'll be right back. Lineups, keys, a whole lot more coming up on the pregame show.
This program on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you by ATI Physical Therapy, taking physical therapy to a higher level. Ask your doctor about ATI Physical Therapy.
They treat you like you're their best friend or your family. It's almost like they can't do enough for you.
Hello, I'm Dan Fields of the Fields Auto Group. We simply treat people the way we want to be treated.
I get a personal treatment here, and I recommend it.
It includes our free loaners, free car washes, and cafes. It's all part of the Fields Matters program.
I'm looking for the best price, and Fields gives you that. That's why we've bought so many cars from them.
Fields matters because you matter.
FieldsAuto.com.
Yeah, not us.
Nah, no reruns here.
Yeah, we have X1 from Xfinity.
Everybody crochet tonight.
I think we'll just stick with our TV shows.
Don't fall for DirecTV. Get four times more TV shows and movies on demand with Xfinity. Sign up today or get started with this great offer. Call or go online today.
So, you are all set with your mortgage. Congratulations.
You have been so helpful, Brian.
You've answered all our questions.
Thanks. That's very important.
What was it like for your siblings growing up with a mortgage prodigy?
Did you have to wake up early to train at mortgages?
No. At BMO Harris, we all focus on making everything go smoothly. Actually, when I was a kid, I wanted to be a cowboy.
A mortgage cowboy?
Yeah, kind of.
That feeling you get when you discover a bank built for you, that's the BMO effect. BMO Harris Bank. We're here to help.
For small business owners, there's never enough time in the day. Carly goes from cooking for three people to catering for 300. Basically, we're her back office. Whether it's having flyers available at her venues, banners, posters, we'll be here to help tell her story. And she knows that. Carly knows that.
From printing to packing, shipping to marketing, together, there's nothing we can't solve. Go to a UPS store today to see how.
Chicago's favorite spot for prime steaks, the freshest seafood, and world-famous Florida stone crab. Come on down to Joe's.
You're watching Cubs pregame live, presented by Fields Auto Group. Now back to Cap and Holly.
All right, time for our ATI injury report. Everyone knows Kyle Schwarber lost for the season with torn knee ligaments last week. Minor league third baseman Christian Villanueva also likely done for the year after having surgery on a fractured fibula. Dallas Beeler on the 15-day DL with shoulder inflammation. Aaron Brooks, 15-day DL, a hip contusion. Zach Roscoe currently on a 60-day DL with left shoulder inflammation. All right, time now for the lineup for the Chicago Cubs, brought to you by our friends at Wrigleyville Sports. Bit of a different lineup today for Joe Madden, Holly. Fowler in center, Bryant bats second, he's at third. Rizzo in the three hole at first, Soler's in left, Baez gets the start at second, Russell's in short, Caesar's in right, David Ross is catching today, and Jake Arrieta is on the ball.
Let me tell you something, Cappy. I love what we got at the top. I mean, Fowler's been raking all season long. Short, you know, here we at the beginning of the season. But Brian Rizzo, I love what we got going. 4, 5, 6, and 7, man. I am just jacked to see this play. Soler, Baez, Russell's moved up in the lineup. Caesar's in there today. This is a new look. I'm pretty excited to see how this is going to play itself out, but I'm really excited to see what these guys can do together up a little bit higher in the lineup.
All right, let's talk about Javi Baez. I had a nice chat with him today in the Cubs clubhouse, and I said, you look smaller. Have you lost weight? He said, actually, I have. I've lost 15, almost 20 pounds. And I said, you weren't a big guy last year. He said, no, I was playing between 215, 218, right in that range. He said, they want me to be able to work in the outfield. I got to be quicker. So he took off, he said, a little more than 15 pounds. He said, I feel better, I move better.
Well, that's the most important thing, Cap. When it comes to baseball players and weight loss or weight gain or muscle build or whatever, it's got to be a complete conviction. You got to be doing it with all the confidence in the world that the results that you're going to get from all the work in the winter is going to translate into positive energy on the field. And if Baez believes that he's going to be a better baseball player, losing 20 pounds, that he's going to have a better first step and first quick step, so be it. But you've got to do it with conviction. So I'm hoping that's what we see. Personally, I didn't think he needed to lose the weight, but if he believed it and he thinks he's going to be better for it, that's it. That's how it works.
He said he's playing now at 195.
Wow, that's a lot of weight loss.
That's a lot of weight loss.
Yeah.
So much different for him. So look at the Rockies lineup today. They'll have Adams at second. Story, who's still on that historic home run pace here at the start of the season, to short. Cargo is at right. Nolan Arenado, great player at third. Parra, Reynolds, Rayburn, Garneau, and the pitcher is Christian Bergman. Let's talk about our Built for Business, brought to you by Comcast Business. Cargo, Carlos Gonzalez, leadoff single in the sixth yesterday, extended his hitting streak to 20 games dating back to last season, hitting 400 during the hitting streak. In his career against the Cubs, Cargo hitting 343 in 36 games with 12 home runs and 26 RBIs. Comcast Business, Built for Business. Cargo is a big-time player.
Well, he's one of the game's premier outfielders, there's no doubt about it. 40 home runs last year, reestablished himself. The only thing that anybody doubts about his game is the injuries. This guy's a good defender, not a great defender, not what he was earlier in his career, but one of the best hitters in the game. He's got a great swing, uses the entire field, has power to all fields. And I wouldn't be surprised if the Rockies end up trading him by year's end. This is a guy who was right there with Tulo. Everybody's been wondering for a very long time, were they going to trade Tulo? Will they trade Cargo? His name comes up constantly. So we'll see what happens because he's off to a great start.
Yeah, and he brings tremendous thump to a lineup.
Yes, he does.
So we'll see. You never know. If Soler proves he can handle left, then he stays there. But if he doesn't, that could be a guy the Cubs look at.
Well,
he's got, I think, another year left on his deal after this year.
That he does. But, you know, again, when you're getting the kind of production that you're getting out of him right now, it's well worth it, the pennies that you might be giving up to get him. He is at the end of his contract, but maybe one more year left. Let me say this. There's a lot of guys out there. The Cubs are in a great position to do whatever they need to do, but Cargo's name is going to be out there if he continues to do what he's doing so far this year.
All right, we got to take another timeout. We still have Holly's keys and a little bit more to get to, plus our key performer. It's all coming up next. This is Blue Cross Blue Shield. Cubs pregame live on Comcast SportsNet.
Honda believes in helping you use your garage to its fullest potential. That's why we're offering great deals on the things you'll want in your garage, like the Honda CR-V. The best-selling SUV in America comes with a standard multi-angle rear-view camera. And plenty of cargo space. Great for transporting lots of stuff, say, to storage or the dump. Hurry to the Honda Dream Garage sales event. You've got a garage to fill. The most durable, longest-lasting brand in its class has great deals. Now at your Honda dealer.
Birthday.
Hey, thanks, Cap. I appreciate it.
I got you something.
What'd you give me? Thanks.
It's the Jumbo Bucks you wanted.
Cap, Jumbo Bucks is the new family of instant tickets from the Illinois Lottery. You can win up to $3 million instantly.
Do they take hundreds? I need that back.
Jumbo prizes, excitement, and fun from the Illinois Lottery. Get ready to live large.
Take that back. Bring that back here.
When you're ready to buy a house, a mortgage from U.S. Bank could help make it possible. And a dedicated financial partner will be with you every step of the way. See about pre-qualifying today. U.S. Bank. The power of possible.
4x5 for scenic routes that only you find scenic. For the great outdoors and the great indoors. For knowing boundaries are there to be crossed. 4x4 today, tomorrow, we'll never say never. Jeep Cherokee. It's how we live 4x forever. During 1 week to deal, get 0% financing for 75 months or these cash allowances on 2016 Jeep Cherokee models.
You're watching Cubs pregame live presented by Fields Auto Group. Now back to Captain Holly.
And welcome back on a gorgeous day here on Friendly Confines. We'll have the postgame show a little later this afternoon for you, hopefully after a Cubs victory. Middle infield, a lot of talk about middle infield. You've got Starlin Castro now playing in New York. Last night I'm watching the Yankee game against the Mariners. Check out the play Castro makes. He makes a diving backhanded stop on a line drive, throws to second to double off the runner. Great play by Starlin, and he looks for a settlement at second to drop.
Yeah, Cappy, you know, I told you I got to go to Yankees camp this year and spend some time with Starlin. He's in a really, really good spot. He fits in that clubhouse perfectly. You know, here in Chicago, and I tell this to people here all the time, is that, you know, the player that you're seeing in New York right now, I'm not sure you would have seen here. The circumstances were different. It was a different group, a different type of team. In the Bronx, he's got older guys, a lot of older guys around him, veterans, guys who naturally grab the spotlight and grab the attention. Starlin has kind of come in under the radar, just played his game. People are starting to take notice now, but again, it's going to be about A-Rod and Teixeira and CeCe Sabathia and Jacoby Ellsbury. There's just a lot of big names on that team, and he's in a perfect spot. He kind of falls more in line with Didi Gregorius there, but for us here in Chicago, he was our star player.
All right, let's also talk about Addison Russell. He, of course, took over at short when Starlin was benched and then eventually moved to second last season. Is this the year he can win a gold glove, or he'll get there, but not quite this quickly?
Nope. I'm convinced. I absolutely believe he's going to win a Gold Glove this year. His defense was outstanding. It was the best in the game last year. I was telling you about the defensive metric war, He just didn't play enough last year to kind of outnumber some of his competition. With that being said, he's got a full season. You're going to see him win not only one Gold Glove, you're going to see him win a boatload of Gold Gloves.
All right. We'll take one more timeout, and then we'll get Holly's keys to the game. Cubs and Rockies on a gorgeous Saturday in the greatest city in the world. We'll be right back at Comcast SportsNet.
Sports Authority is proud to be the official sporting goods retailer of the Chicago Cubs. To shop online or find a store near you, visit sportsauthority.com.
For the we and team. That's why we're here. This week, get great deals on the best brands like Nike, Under Armour, Easton, and more. Only at Sports Authority.
What would we be without our mountains? Without the things that stand in our way? That make us better? At Coors, our mountain is brewing the world's most refreshing beer. Lagered, filtered, and packaged cold. Our mountains make us who we are. Your mountains make you who you are. Whatever your mountain, climb on.
Hello, beautiful. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Hi, Anthony. How much did my discount double check save me?
About $150.
Done.
I don't have State Farm, but insurance, find me money.
I got you a dollar.
Oh, you almost had it. You gotta be quicker than that.
Having insurance isn't the same as having State Farm. There to help you with unexpected savings. That's getting to a better state.
Update your bathroom with a complete toilet from Menards. The Astute Vormax toilet comes with everything you need for a quick and easy installation. Its revolutionary vortex flushing system completely cleans the entire bowl. Just $269. Save big on designer's image vinyl flooring at Menards. Vinyl tiles are durable and easy to install. Silver series tiles in six patterns, just 79 cents each. And the Platinum series in eight patterns, only $139 each.
Save big money at Menards.
Thank you. Ordering Chinese food is a very predictable experience. I order B14, I get B14. No surprises. Buying business internet, on the other hand, can be a roller coaster white knuckle thrill ride. You're promised one speed, but do you consistently get it? You do with Comcast Business. It's reliable, just like Kung Pao fish. Thank you, Pink.
Reliably fast internet starts at $59.95 a month. Comcast Business, built for business.
You're watching Cubs pregame live presented by Fields Auto Group.
All right, Cubs and Rockies, game two of a three-game weekend set, and then it's off to St. Louis for the Cubs. They will play in the Lou on Monday evening. Cap and Holly back with you on our Fields Auto Group Cubs pregame live. We'll have the postgame show from the studio a little later this afternoon. Time for Todd Hollinsworth's keys to the game.
All right, let's get it done. I like the matchup today. I feel really good about this one. To start, we got Jake Arrieta. Doesn't matter. Key number one, Rockies lefties. Now, yesterday, we're talking a little cargo here, talking a little para in particular. Six of their 10 hits yesterday came from the lefties. They also drove in three of their four runs. Now, Kyle Hendricks was going. You pair that with Jake's splits, which I, you kind of pick up here in the early going. Lefties have hit 368 against them. That's something that kind of catches my attention. Got to be heads up for Cargo in particular, but Mara as well. He swung the bat well yesterday. We got to keep the Rockies lefties under wraps today. Now, groundwork. Groundwork is key number two. As I mentioned earlier, when the ball's been put in play against Jake Arrieta, 62% of the time, it's been on the ground. That is absolutely outstanding. It's what you want. It's what aces do. But we pair that with what happened yesterday. We made four errors. I don't like that, but it's got to be cleaned up today. So something to keep your eye on, the groundwork. You're going to see a lot of ground balls off the bat today. Hopefully a lot of strikeouts go along with Arrieta's performance. But if the ball's on the ground, we got to be making the plays behind him. Back on track, getting this offense rolling. Yesterday, a little bit of a down day, but you're going up against Bergman. Cappy, you mentioned the splits. I get it. Frankly, I don't care. His stuff's not good enough to get through this lineup too many times. I'm looking for the Cubs to bust out early in this ballgame. So let's see if we can't get things rolling quickly today.
See, the conditions certainly seem to be ripe for much better.
Beautiful day.
Than we saw how cold it was the other day.
Well, when you're a hitter and, you know, your fingers don't ring off foul balls or miss hits, you're in a good spot. And when we know, when Wrigley Field starts to play like this, hitters get real excited to go out there and do damage, and today could easily be one of those days.
All right, time for our key performers. You get to go first because you've grabbed a very quick 4-1 lead this year.
Yeah, I'm off and rolling. I'm going to go Jorge Soler. I love the spot that he's hitting in the lineup. Threw out a line drive yesterday, a couple good at-bats, but I like where he's at today. I think it inspires him. He's important where he's hitting today, and I think in some regards, you have so much talent on this roster. We've got guys who maybe get a little lost in this lineup. Great to see Addison Russell move up, but I love to see Soler getting a shot at the four spot.
I'm going to go with Chris Bryant. Happy anniversary, Chris. We don't have the game tomorrow on our air. It's actually tomorrow. We'll celebrate his anniversary today.
Right.
And I think he has a big day. He's got a couple home runs this week, and he looks like he's pretty locked in. He's playing his position over at third. I think he'll be ready to go.
I like the pick. He's got a couple homers, had back-to-back a few days ago. But, again, even the base hit the other way yesterday. When you start to pull your homers and play the game and get your base hits the other way, you're starting to really lock in. I actually think it's a pretty strong pick. We'll see where it goes.
All right, for a guy like Bergman, as he faces this lineup, obviously, there's going to be some butterflies. He was supposed to start on Thursday. They said, we're going to move you to Saturday. From a Rocky perspective, how do you handle him?
They're looking for five innings. Good, bad, indifferent. That's what they want. They just don't want to overexpose their bullpen today. They're not. I mean, listen, Bergman's not going seven innings. I would be absolutely stunned. It's his first start. He's been pitching out of the bullpen. This is a real clear opportunity for the Cubs today to go out there, score some runs early, and turn it over to Jake with a lead.
We'll find out today. The Cubs and the Rocks. Game two of this three-game weekend set. Jake Arrieta will go to the hill. We will be live from CSN after the ball game and get you all caught up on what transpired today. Hopefully talk about a Cubs victory. Kelly Crow will have in-game updates. We will see you after the ball game. Len and JD are coming up next. For Todd Hollinsworth, our great crew, I'm David Kaplan. It's Len and Jim Deshaies show next.
All right, Cap, Holly, thank you very much. Our first winter capless day for JD here at Wrigley Field. But warming up a little bit and beautiful weather.
Beautiful down on the field. A little cooler here in the shade, but a great day to play. Not quite as pitcher friendly as we've seen in recent days and nights. Should be an interesting ball game today. We've got a very lopsided pitching matchup, and those always scare you, right? Arrieta, the reigning Cy Young Award winner, who's been so good here. And the youngster Christian Bergman making a spot start out of the bullpen for the Rockies.
Let's go back to yesterday, game one of this series. And it was really the first day where nothing really went right for the Cubs. The Rockies played terrific defense all over the diamond. You mentioned the Gold Glovers, and those guys came to play. Parra, LeMahieu, Gonzalez helping out their pitcher, Chad Bettis. Didn't think Kyle Hendricks was that bad. He didn't get a ton of help.
No, I thought Kyle Hendricks threw the ball well, threw a ton of strikes. Sinker was working well for him. A little sloppy play defensively. Chris Bryant made a couple errors. That's a very difficult error on Addison Russell there. Actually made a heck of a play with the glove. And then fielder's choice there, and a little mishandled by Rizzo on a do-or-die play. So, yeah, sloppy play, maybe day game after night game. But all added up to a 6-1 Rocky win.
Cubs still ranked third in the majors in defensive efficiency despite those four errors. And today they turn to the ace, who's also hitting the ball out of the ballpark. One of the longer home runs we've seen in a while in his second start of the year. He did give up some runs, but pitched like Jake normally pitches.
Yeah, I mean, he has set the bar so high. He allowed three runs in seven innings. He gave up a couple home runs in that ball game, one to Goldschmidt, the other one to Socrates Brito. It was his first major league home run. But at the end of the day, it was still yet another quality start for Arrieta. He's rattled off 22 in a row of those. And check out what he has done here at Wrigley Field. His last five starts here in this ballpark, he has given up nada.
Right, no runs in his last 40 and two-thirds innings. The last run scored against Jake Arrieta in this ballpark was during Cole Hamels' no-hitter. That was July 25th of 2015. When we come back, we'll talk to his battery mate today, David Ross, with Kelly Crow when we return.
Cubs Pregame Live is presented by Fields Auto Group. Fields matters because you matter. See Fields first. FieldsAuto.com.
They treat you like you're their best friend or your family. It's almost like they can't do enough for you.
Hello, I'm Dan Fields of the Fields Auto Group. We simply treat people the way we want to be treated.
I get a personal treatment here, and I recommend it.
It includes our free loaners, free car washes, and cafes. It's all part of the Fields Matters program.
I'm looking for the best price, and Fields gives you that. That's why we've bought so many cars from them.
Fields matters because you matter.
FieldsAuto.com.
Wow, bear season was incredible, but it was absolutely freezing. So Wrigleyville Sports helped me warm up for bull season. They were on fire all year long. Then came the Blackhawks, and they got hot too. But now the boys of summer are back, and it's time to head to the south side. On second thought, it's a perfect day to get some sun in the bleachers.
Honda believes in helping you use your garage to its fullest potential. That's why we're offering great deals on the things you'll want in your garage, like the Honda CR-V. The best-selling SUV in America comes with a standard multi-angle rear-view camera. And plenty of cargo space. Great for transporting lots of stuff, say to storage or the dump. Hurry to the Honda Dream Garage sales event. You've got a garage to fill.
The most durable, longest-lasting brand in its class has great deals. Now at your Honda dealer.
Christmas lights tangle, and they're so hard to hang, but not anymore. Introducing Star Shower Laser Lights, the easiest way to light up your entire home. In just seconds, you can add thousands of stars everywhere. Instantly, your home is transformed from dark to dazzling, or from simple to spectacular. Christmas, Halloween, the 4th of July. Star Shower even works inside.
When I have a party, I spice it up with Star Shower. I love them, and my guests can't keep their eyes off them.
Lighting your home with these lights is expensive, but with Star Shower laser lights, electricity costs are more than 99% less. Stop wasting hundreds buying new lights year after year. Light up your home with Star Shower laser lights for just $39.99. Call now and we'll give you an instant upgrade to the deluxe red-green dual laser Star Shower. Here's how to order.
Call 1-800-231-2982 to get your Star Shower. Call or go to GetStarShower.com. So call 1-800-231-2982. Rush delivery available. Order right now.
Rockies and Cubs game two coming up. Lots of sunshine. Blue skies above. And we are just minutes away from the first pitch, and Kelly Krall caught up earlier with Cubs veteran catcher David Ross.
All right, thanks a lot, guys, here with David Ross. Game two against the Rockies. David, I want to go back. You watched kind of what unfolded yesterday in game one, and it seemed really uncharacteristic of this team. I mean, how do you just chalk that up to just kind of letting it go and then come back today? The 24-hour rule, as Joe likes to call it.
Yeah, that was an ugly one yesterday. you just kind of, I mean, we know baseball and these guys, when you go through a full season, you understand how many games we have, and you're going to have bad days. Everybody has them, and we had a couple guys have bad ones yesterday, so just part of it, and that's usually how I end up pitching in the back of the end of a game sometimes, just when everybody has a bad day. But, you know we have a good team, and we're going to have some off days, and, we're 8-2. If you started season and said we could start off, first 10 games 8-2, I think we would all take that in here. So we're just going to go out and try to approach each day as its own, and that's what we plan on doing today, going out there and putting our best foot forward.
Good to know you weren't warming up then yesterday.
No, thank goodness.
Well, and how about having Jake follow that up? It's so nice to be like, oh, well, we're just going to throw our, Cy Young winner out there then tomorrow.
Yeah, that's the nice thing about having good pitching is that, even Kyle threw pretty good yesterday, but knowing you got the reigning Cy Young Award winner going the next day always is a comfort. And again, we try to take each day as its own and go out there and put our best foot forward and let these guys attack the opposing pitcher, how we game plan for him. And Jake's going to have to throw well today. They got a really good lineup. It's a good team. This is the major leagues. Everybody we play is good. So this is a really good team over there. And we're going to go out there and try to figure out a way to beat them today.
You mentioned the 8-2 start. I know getting off to a hot start was something Joe addressed. You guys addressed with some of the younger guys how important that is to a season. But does it surprise you at all that it has come together so quickly? I mean, despite, just one game here or there.
No, I don't think so. I think in spring training, the back end, when guys started getting together, the full team, I think we wanted to we play well together, and we started to do that in the spring training. And so to hit our stride, I mean, it was a good team in Arizona that we were playing. Anaheim was a tough bunch. So it was nice to get home and play against Cincinnati. But we know there's better competition ahead, like Colorado, like St. Louis. The road ahead is going to be tough. So it's a long season. A lot of things can happen. And so we just try to approach it each day. And we've done a good job so far of individualizing the day. And, we've had a bad day here. There, but it's going to happen.
Total sidebar here, but I think Chris Bryant, this is kind of the anniversary weekend for 1 year in the majors for him, and he said he might rent out the party room and throw himself in. How does that sound? I mean, that seems right?
Yeah, it's funny how established these guys are already, and, they got a year in, but I feel like they've been here, him and Schwarbs and Addy, I feel like they've been here a lot longer than a year. It's crazy to look back on that, and neither one of them have a year. So, we'll give him some razz today. I'm glad you reminded me of that, because I'll rip him a little bit today about not getting too comfy.
Oh, no, I just did that, but I know it'll be all in good fun. David, thank you so much.
You
appreciate
it. Anytime, Kelly.
Guys.
Good stuff, Kelly, with David Ross. So Ross, Baez, Caesar all in the lineup today.
Yeah, I had a chance to talk to Javi a little bit when I got to the ballpark this morning. He had a little extra bounce in his step. Very excited to get his 2016 season started. It's going to be interesting to see how Joe Maddon uses him. But at second today, we'll see him at short from time to time. You got to get the kids some at-bats.
And by the way, this is career game number 162 for the aforementioned Chris Bryant. Now down to the field, John Vincent with our national anthem.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing and join John Vincent as he honors America with our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free? And the hope of the brave.
That's how you do it. John Vincent, take a breath, young man. Cubs hosting the Rockies on a gorgeous day at Wrigley coming up.
What's the most awarded car company of the year?
Ranking from top to bottom.
Luxury cars seem like they would be top awarded.
Better be some awards behind what you're paying for, right?
The final answer?
Uh-oh. Oh. Chevy, the most awarded car company 2 years in a row.
Wow, it's like a luxury car.
I was shocked. I mean, it's like, this is Chevy?
For a limited time, get cash back for 15% of the MSRP on most remaining 2015 Chevy vehicles while they last. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
Yeah, not us.
No, no reruns here.
Yeah, we have X1 from Xfinity.
Everybody crochet tonight.
I think we'll just stick with our TV shows.
Don't fall for DirecTV. Get 4 times more TV shows and movies on demand with Xfinity. Sign up today or get started with this great offer. Call or go online today.
Let's go. That's pretty sweet.
The starting lineup for your Chicago Bulls.
This is the most ridiculous thing that's ever happened in my life.
This Camry's got everything I'm looking for. Available features like pre-collision system, V6 engine, Qi wireless smartphone charging. Look at that front grille.
Don't forget Toyota Care.
Right, Toyota Care.
Want to take a test drive?
Yeah.
Get 0% APR for 60 months plus $500 bonus cash on a new 2016 Camry or lease Camry for only $199 per month. Toyota, let's go places.
to Chicago Cubs baseball on CSN, presented to you by State Farm. Another big crowd on hand and a gorgeous day for Cubs baseball here on CSN. The Chicago Cubs host the Colorado Rockies. Great to have you with us alongside Jim DeShays. I'm Len Casper. Cubs 8-2, off to a great start. Yesterday, not so good, but it's only one day.
It's the nature of baseball. Even the best teams are going to have a clunker from time to time. I believe Joe Madden says they can't all be oil paintings. Yesterday was a little ugly, but you see the first nine games better than 7 runs per game. A lot of hits, a lot of walks, high on base percentage. Yesterday, they just scored the singleton, managed just 4 hits. That kid, Chad Bettis, the youngster for the Rockies, was really good.
Well, we talked last weekend when we saw the Diamondbacks, two of the best first basemen in the league, and Paul Goldschmidt and Anthony Rizzo. We're going to go across the diamond today. Nolan Arenado and Chris Bryant.
Yeah, it could be a brokered convention for the All-Star game between these two guys. And for the foreseeable future, Arenado is turning 25 today. Chris Bryant's 24, two of the best third basemen. Not young third basemen, just best third baseman, period, in all of baseball.
Interesting matchup today. It'll be the first time the Rockies have used a fifth starter. Spot start for Christian Bergman. And the Cubs going with their ace. Jake Arrieta tries to improve to 3-0. First pitch is next.
Add a timeless look with Rapid Lock engineered hardwood flooring from Menards. It installs easily with no glue or nails required. Cambria oak is $199 a square foot. Natural hickory is only $249 a square foot. Menards is your destination for window treatments. 1-inch vinyl blinds from Window Images start at $799. Plus, they can be custom trimmed to any width for free. Volley special order window treatments give the perfect look to any room. Right now, they're 25% off.
Save big money at Menards.
As a young man, I worked in the steel mills, where I learned the value of honest hard work. It's also where I saw firsthand how lives can be changed by tragic moments, how individuals or their families struggled in the aftermath. And it was then that I decided my life's work, that while I may not be able to prevent tragic moments, I could fight to help better the lives of those who suffered them.
Huge spring sell-off during the spring clearance event at Feeney Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Elgin. Get our lowest prices on our entire inventory. Cars, trucks, minivans, and more Jeeps than we need. All with 0% financing available. Look at this 2016 Wrangler, just $299 a month. Or a 2016 Ram 1500 Quad Cab, $299 a month. Both with zero due. Or this 2016 Dodge Caravan, only $16,997. Find it at Feeney. FeeneyAutos.com.
Cubs baseball on CSN Chicago is brought to you in part by your Chicago area and Northwest Indiana Lexus dealer, who invites you to test drive a Lexus today. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Illinois, through it all. Ford, inviting you to check out their fuel-efficient lineup at your local Ford store or at localfordstores.com. And by Southwest Airlines, transparency, low fares, nothing to hide.
Look at that. Gorgeous day. And the temperature rising as each day moves along. A little cool in the shade, beautiful in the sun. And Jake Arrieta on the mound here at Wrigley Field. Rockies Southwest starting lineup. Christian Adames spot start for DJ LeMahieu today. Trevor Story hitless yesterday. Only the second time to start the season. Cargo has hit in 20 in a row going back to the end of last year. Arenado, Para, Reynolds in the middle. Ryan Rayburn, the left fielder. Dustin Garno, the catcher. And Christian Bergman, don't know how long he'll go, but probably not too deep into this game.
A little different look for the Cubs defensively this afternoon as Caesar gets a start. He's out there in the outfield with Fowler and Soler. They're actually flip-flops. He's just going to play right, Soler left. Bryant Russell Baez gets a start at second, and Big Riz at first. Grandpa Ross behind the plate for our Lexus Pursuing Perfection starting pitcher. It's Jake Arrieta, the big righty, off to a great start here in 2016 as he looks to defend his Cy Young Award. Two starts, two wins, a 1.93 ERA. 40 and two-thirds consecutive scoreless here at Wrigley. 22 consecutive quality starts for Arrieta dating back to last year. During that stretch, he is 18-1 with a 0.95 earned run average. You want more? I'll give you more. Since August 1st of last year, 14 starts, 13 wins, no losses, and a 0.62 ERA. It's enough to make a Rocky hitter stay in bed.
Bill Welke is the crew chief today. John Hirschbeck had to leave the game early yesterday after taking a foul ball that hit the dirt and came up, caught him in the jaw or the chin. So he will not work the rest of this weekend, and we certainly hope he is all right. Carapazza, Fagan, and Marvin Hudson around the bases. So the switch hitting Christian Adames will start it. His first start of the year. And the switch hitter fouls to get us underway. Rockies, six runs, sorry, J.D., with no extra base hits yesterday.
Yeah, it was a weird day, just an odd game. I mean, they didn't get anything out of the top of their batting order. Nolan Arenado did not hit the ball out of the infield, but they did manage to score six runs.
Popped up bunt attempt, foul. -54 degrees, east wind at 5. So the wind has kind of been similar here these last few days in terms of the direction. The 0-2. Swing and a miss, strike three.
Twelve strikeouts against one walk in the first two starts for Arrieta, and he beats Adames with a high heater there. Jake will go consistently in that 94 to 96 range with the fastball. But the lane-changing slider, good curveball, the changeup has turned into a great weapon for him as well.
Here's Trevor's story. 0-4-5 yesterday. A couple of strikeouts. And he's down 0-1. And we'd like to welcome all our viewers watching on Ligtel Communications, Ligonier, Indiana. Swing and a miss.
That thing found another gear. Hop on that heater. Story is a little bit of an uppercut swing. He's an extreme fly ball hitter. And early on, the ball's been flying out of the ballpark for him.
First time he's missed. Get back out of play. The top three offensive clubs in terms of runs per game right now are the Cardinals, the Cubs, and the Rockies. And we will see the Cardinals on Monday.
Cardinals hit six home runs in their ball game yesterday against the Reds.
Swing and a miss. Back-to-back K's to start it for Arrieta.
I love that shot right there. That camera, that look from behind home plate. You see the way he closes off that front side, has that little rocking motion, hides the ball, creates deception to go along with that outstanding stuff.
Here's Gonzalez. He's hit in all 10 to start this season. Hit two hits yesterday. Cubs over shift to the right on the infield.
Finished last year with a 10-game hitting streak and starts this year with a 10-game streak.
Well, he's the fourth player, according to Elias, in the last 50 years to do that. And one season with at least a 10-gamer, and start the next year with one.
I would say the big righty's feeling pretty crisp out there today as he looks to punch out the side from the top of the first.
Fans already standing, and we're 10 pitches into the ball game. The 0-2 is outside.
It's the changeup.
And we'll do it again. Rockies have won three in a row. They're 6-4 through 10. Cubs are 8-2. Already their sixth game against the National League West. Here it is. Swing and a miss. Arrieta strikes out the side. In his home debut here in 2016. Cubs coming up when we come back.
When did paying for airfare become so unfair? At Southwest, we believe in transparency. Transparency means we don't dream up ways we can trick you into paying more. It's why we still let two bags fly free and don't have change fees. So our low fares stay low. Just the way you like it.
T-Mobile hit it out of the park. We doubled our LTE coverage to cover over 305 million Americans. And our new extended range LTE goes two times farther and works four times better in buildings than before. Switch to T-Mobile for major league coverage today.
Nobody should go to bed hungry.
That's where our friends at Benny's Beverage Depot are going to bat for the Greater Chicago Food Depository.
Every time the Cubs leadoff man gets a hit, Benny's donates $100 to help feed hungry families in Chicagoland.
That calls for a toast.
Before earning enough cash back from Bank of America to buy a new gym bag. Before earning 1% cash back everywhere, every time. And 2% back at the grocery store. Even before he got 3% back on gas. Kenny used his Bank AmeriCard Cash Rewards credit card to join the Wednesday Night League. Because he loves to play hoops, not jump through them. That's the excitement of rewarding connections. Apply online or at a Bank of America near you.
If today's Cubs leadoff man gets a hit, Benny's Beverage Depot will donate $100 to the Greater Chicago Food Depository. And pretty decent chance that'll happen because Dexter Fowler comes in hitting .424 on the year. And the rest of the Cubs Southwest starting lineup looks like this. Chris Bryant is moving up and hitting second. Anthony Rizzo, Jorge Soler in the cleanup. Javier Baez makes his season debut. Russell batting sixth. Matt Caesar is in right today. David Ross, the catcher. And Jake Arrieta, the pitcher. Christian Bergman, swingman, making a spot start. And ball one on the ex-Rocky. Dexter Fowler.
Bergman, the Alexis pursuing perfection starting pitcher for the Rockies here this afternoon. He's worked a couple times out of the bullpen, and not much of a sample there to go on. But, he's a strike thrower, not a hard thrower. His velocity, 88 to 90 miles an hour. Slider, good changeup. Occasionally a curveball. It's all about command for him. It's a good change.
27. Years old. He'll turn 28 on May 4th. He's filling the role. as he'll handle Fowler, left by John Gray, who was on the disabled list.
Well, Rockies defensively, they've got the Gold Glover sprinkled around the diamond. Parra and Gonzalez, both Gold Glovers in the outfield. They're joined by Ryan Rayburn, the veteran in left. Arenado has won three consecutive Gold Gloves to start his career. Story, the youngsters committed just one error so far. Adames and Reynolds will patrol the right side, and Dustin Garneau will do the catching today.
Chris Bryant takes a strike. Yeah, Gray on the DL with an abdominal issue and might be ready for the next turn through the rotation. Again, number 162 in terms of games played for Chris Bryant. This is his 697th career plate appearance. 24 years old. We had the comparison in the open with Nolan Arenado, who turns 25 today. So the Cubs trying to spoil his birthday. 2-2. Basically a bullpen day now for the Rockies. We do not expect Bergman to go too deep into this game. Called strike three. They get Bryant.
Bergman taking a page out of Chad Bettis' playbook. The starter yesterday worked very quickly. Bergman doing the same here today, and that one touches the bottom of the knees.
That will bring up Anthony Rizzo. Snapped an 0 for 19 with a sixth inning single yesterday.
Some splits on Bergman. Had more success out of the bullpen as a starter. A 6.14 ERA. He's made 14 career starts.
Oh, and one.
This is his first ever appearance here at Wrigley Field. Same for the catcher Garneau.
I think it's the first time he's ever been in this ballpark. Two. Soler on deck. And he'll have to lead off the second.
Cubs baseball on CSN is presented to you by State Farm.
Hello, beautiful. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Hi, Anthony. How much did my discount double check save me?
About $150.
Done. I don't have State Farm, but insurance, find me money.
I got you a dollar. Oh, you almost had it. You gotta be quicker than that.
Having insurance isn't the same as having State Farm. There to help you with unexpected savings. That's getting to a better state.
Try friending the way it was meant to be. The weekend is just the beginning. And start now at the Bass Pro Shops Workender event and sale. With great deals throughout the store, plus free demos, social hour, and great prizes. April 22nd and 23rd.
Clean up at Cricket Wireless. Switch and get select 4G LTE smartphones for as low as $19.99. Plus, no annual contracts. New phone smell. Cricket Wireless. Something to smile about.
Great things start in garages. Like the start of your perfect Honda collection with great deals during the Honda Dream Garage sales event.
Including the all-new Honda Civic. The best-selling car in its class now has a redesigned exterior.
Nice wheels. Care to upgrade?
Yeah. Oh, hey, yes, I do.
Yeah. Hurry in. You've got a garage to fill. The Honda Dream Garage sales event has great deals on the all-new Civic. Now at your Honda dealer.
Make sure you follow In-Game Live on CSNChicago.com, presented by State Farm. Pretty impressive first inning for both starting pitchers. Arrieta struck out the side. Bergman, 1-2-3, fanned two, so nobody has yet hit the ball out of the infield, and here is the birthday boy, Nolan Arenado. He scored twice yesterday, but did not knock in a run for the first time in five games. He had 11 RBIs his previous four. Leads the majors with 14 knocked in. And 130 last year to pace MLB. We haven't even talked about his defense yet. High sky today is... Russell makes the catch. That's where spending 6 weeks in Arizona helps.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a challenge on a day like today, man. That's a high sky overhead. Bright blue, no clouds to break it up. Got a little breeze as well. He's using that glove to shade his eyes as best he can, all the while calling. Well done.
Now, Gerardo Parra. Coming off his third consecutive two-hit game. Began the year as their left fielder, but he's going to play a lot of center with Charlie Blackman on the disabled list.
He loves hitting here. Lifetime 371 at Wrigley. That's the best among active players with at least 20 games in this ballpark.
So the Rockies without an extra base hit yesterday, but they do lead the majors with 49. 2-2.
Parra had his best home run year last year. He hit 14. You think of him more as a singles and doubles guy.
Terrific defender in the outfield. Arrieta quickly to Rizzo.
The Cubs' next homestand will feature three games with the Brewers and a weekend set with the Braves. Tickets are going fast. Visit Cubs.com today. Plan for the games you'd like to see all season long. A reminder, the Cubs have added metal detectors at all Wrigley Field gates. Gates will open 2 hours before each game. Please make sure to give yourself extra time to enter the ballpark. For additional information, visit Cubs.com/security.
Well, you've got a big-time strikeout pitcher and a guy at the plate who has fanned a lot. 1,526 career strikeouts for Mark Reynolds. That tied for the 52nd most in Major League history, currently with Willie Mays. Reynolds has played in 1,265 games. Mays played in 2,992. Baez, a nice play to get there, but not a good throw, and the barrier saved him from an error. That ball nearly went out of play.
I've chalked that up to the exuberance of youth. He didn't pay a price, and he'll be reminded in the dugout. Hey, Javi, just put that one in your back pocket. Unfortunately, it didn't trickle into the dugout and give Reynolds an extra base.
So now it's Ryan Raber. Back-to-back starts for the first time this season. He went 2-for-3 on Friday. Deep breath by Arrieta. And behind now 2-0. Jake was born in Missouri, grew up in Texas, went to Weatherford College, And then Texas Christian University turned 30 on March 6th. Popped up. Still nobody's hit one out of the infield. Baez makes the grab. We go to the bottom of the second, scoreless.
For the last 5 days, 17 hours, and 23 minutes, you've been a passenger.
I'm back in baby's arms. How I miss those.
Mazda SkyActiv technology makes it good to be a driver.
Belong back in baby's arms.
Great time for a shiny floor wax, no? Not if you just put the finishing touches on your latest masterpiece. Timing's important. Comcast Business knows that. That's why you can schedule an installation at a time that works for you, even late at night or on the weekend if that's what you need, because you have enough to worry about. I did not see that coming.
Don't deal with disruptions. Get better internet installed on your schedule. Comcast Business, built for business.
When a day's work was mining for gold under the frozen ground for 12 straight hours, happy hour had a whole new meaning. And when the men sat down for their banquet, Mr. Coors brought a beer worthy of the occasion, a beer that's still known as the banquet beer.
Field as we head to the bottom of the second, still scoreless. Javier Baez due up this inning, his Wrigley Field debut this season, if you will, and he is pumped to be up here and finally healthy. And he said after a couple up and down seasons, his biggest goal this year is consistency, both at the plate and in the field. And certainly Joe Maddon knows that the more playing time he can get him, the more comfortable he will be. He would love to get him out there, guys, 2 to 3 times a week, he said, of course, filling in for Ben Zobrist today, but he also would love to use him for Addison Russell or even in the field, guys.
Okay, Kelly, thank you. Jorge Soler with a leadoff single.
Well, and here comes Baez. He's going to get that chance now to do a little something following up that leadoff single by Soler. John Mailey down the batting cage today talking about Soler, really likes his approach of late. See him laying off those outside sliders yesterday.
So his season debut, nice job by Garneau to keep that ball in front of him and keep Soler at first. I saw a quote from Javi when he was on his rehab assignment, because remember the injury, the left thumb bruise, occurred on a headfirst slide in spring training. He's trying to condition himself to generally go feet first as a result. But you can get hurt doing both. It was a headfirst slide into first, which is usually frowned upon.
Yeah, unless there's an errant throw and you're looking to avoid a tag, you're quicker if you stay upright and run through the base.
Tap to third, tough play, Arenado, and late infield hit, Baez, and the Cubs have two on with nobody out.
Not pretty play by Arenado, but Baez runs well. Not only that, he runs fast, and he's got himself an infield knock, chance for a little early noise here in the bottom of the second. You might not need much with Arrieta on the mound. Big chance here for Addison Russell.
Here is Russell. 5-game hitting streak, following a 2-for-17 in his first 5 games this season.
It's a right-handed leading lineup for Joe Maddon today, and you might say, well, that's kind of weird with a righty on the mound, but when you look at the right-left splits for Bergman in his career, it makes perfect sense. He's been far better against left-handed hitters than right-handed hitters.
Double play ball. Story and Adames team up on a 6-4-3. And that will leave it up to Matt Caesar with two outs and a runner at third.
Just kind of rolled over on that one and fairly routine double play.
Second start for Matt, fifth career start in right field. Can play all three spots in the outfield. One ball, no strikes.
Left-right splits for Bergman in his career, far better against lefties. He's got a good changeup, and I think that's what helps neutralize them. And he doesn't have a real good breaking pitch, and that's probably why the right-handers have had success.
He's been efficient here early as Carlos Gonzalez makes a catch. Cubs cannot convert.
Taking the hassle out of yard work just got even easier. During the Echo National Sales Event, get a pro-grade Echo trimmer or handheld blower for only $149.99 each, backed by a 5-year warranty. But hurry, these deals will be gone before you know it. So take back your yard with Echo.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by the authority of the Chicago Cubs and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form. And the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the Chicago Cubs.
I'm attorney Howard Ankin. If you've been hurt at work or injured in an auto accident, I'd like to be your lawyer. Please call me at 312-600-0000. Ankin Law. Injury law. Made personal.
When you're ready to buy a house, a mortgage from U.S. Bank could help make it possible. And a dedicated financial partner will be with you every step of the way. See about pre-qualifying today. U.S. Bank, the power of possible.
When you call one, you call them all.
During 1 week to deal, get 4,000 combined cash allowance plus 500 bonus cash on the 2016 Grand Caravan.
Today, the Chicago Fire look to extend their unbeaten streak to 4 games as they defend home field against the first place Montreal Impact. Coverage starts at 3:30 on CSN Plus. Scoreless tie as we start the third inning. Catcher Dustin Garneau. So they had Justin Morneau and Dustin Garneau last year. Morneau has not signed with anybody. So dealt with some concussion issues. Rockies also today, coincidentally, placed their catcher Nick Hundley on the 7-day concussion disabled list. Took a ball off the mask the other day. So Garneau replaced Charlie Blackman on the active roster. David Hale is here, a right-hander, and we'll probably see him pitch today. He replaces Hundley. So you've got some inexperience back of the plate now with Hundley out for a bit. with Garneau and Walters, who was pretty impressive yesterday.
Yeah. Solid behind the plate. Had a good day at the plate. Can run a little bit. He's stolen three bases already this year.
Three balls, two strikes. Pitcher Bertman is on deck.
Garneau cannot sit on a fastball here. Jake threw him a 2-0 slider for strike one in this sequence.
Out, and he rocketed one in and out of the visitor's dugout.
Garneau was a 19th round pick. Bergman, the pitcher, 24th round pick. Making their Wrigley Field debuts here today.
A line drive out into the gap. He's trying for two. The throw there. He's safe. A leadoff double as Garneau took a chance. But when you're facing Jake Arrieta, I think it's probably a good risk to take.
Yeah, I think it makes sense to push it a little bit. And the play was in front of him. A heck of a throw by Caesar. Just in ahead of that tag.
Yeah, and if he kept his hand on the base, he was definitely safe. Cubs are making sure, and Joe will not challenge. So here's the pitcher, Bergman, who will try to bunt his battery mate to third. Hit over 340 as a high school senior in La Cañada, California. Knocked down by Ross.
We'll make it easy for him. Rizzo will not. He'll be right up in his grill there. Ideally for Bergman, he'd like to bunt this ball towards Bryant, force him to abandon third base. Rizzo's too aggressive. They may let Bergman pull the bat back and try to slap it by him.
Arrieta will try to work out of this. He has not allowed a run in this ballpark since July 25th of last year. Covers almost 43 innings. Didn't look very comfortable as Bergman fouled it.
Almost got it done. Arrieta did not pitch against the Rockies last year. He's faced them twice in his career. They both came in 2014. Pitched a real good ball game here against the Rockies, but in Colorado he got knocked around. And that's, you know, there's a lot of pitchers that's the story. Good against him in our park, but up there in Denver, not so much. He allowed career highs in hits and runs in that start in Colorado. 13 hits, 9 runs. It was back in August of 2014.
Dropped by Baez. He's still got time to get Bergman at first. He wanted to throw to third. So Bergman will not get a sacrifice because he swung away, but he got the desired result.
Yeah, he will still get the fist bumps and the high fives in the dugout.
Correct.
As shortened up there, had a shot, would have had a shot at Garneau, I believe, at third base.
Looks to me like Baez has a new teal glove. Cornerman in, back up the middle against Adames, and he takes a strike. And now, with Arrieta ahead in the count, Baez and Russell will move in.
Yeah, ahead in the count, but I also think he's just a little late in getting a notice or recognizing the situation that they should be in.
Yeah, I thought it was odd that they were back to begin with. 0-2.
And, you know, this is one of those baseball decisions. It's not black or white. It's gray whether to play the infield in or back in this situation. Like a lot of managers would keep the infield back this early in the ball game. Because if you have the infield in, you know, there's a chance he pokes one through that drawn in infield. And you got 2-3-4 coming up behind him. But when you've got Arrieta on the mound, you like his chances against just about anybody, regardless of where you are in the batting order. So why concede anything?
Runner's going to hold as Rizzo steps on first. Two outs, and it's the shortstop Story. Arrieta, by the way, did give up four runs here in the playoffs against St. Louis. It was game three of the division series, but when we talk scoreless streaks and the like and batting streaks, that's reserved for the regular season. Although you could make a case, because the playoff games are more important, that that should all kind of count.
Yeah, and just in terms of official record keeping,
right,
we differentiate between the regular season and the postseason.
And that keeps players kind of on a level playing field, because certain guys would have extra chances in those bigger spots. Fouled by Story. To a sizzling start, 0-for-6 in this series. Player of the week in the NL last week. In his first week in the majors, 7 homers in 6 games.
Talked about him being a fly ball hitter. He hasn't really been able to lift the ball yet in this series. I was looking yesterday, it's one of those esoteric stats, is that the cutter, 44%, nearly half of his fly balls had ended up in the seats. Which, one, speaks to his power, and two, there's no way you can sustain that. Ooh, Jake is walking off. Just a little bit outside. And Wilkie gave it a long look, deemed it off the corner, and he was correct.
And he went around, ball gets away from Ross. Scoreless streak here at Wrigley intact through three as Arrieta escapes.
This Camry's got everything I'm looking for. Available features like pre-collision system, V6 engine, Qi wireless smartphone charging. Look at that front grille.
Don't forget Toyota Care.
Right, Toyota Care.
Want to take a test drive?
Yeah.
Get 0% APR for 60 months plus $500 bonus cash on a new 2016 Camry or lease Camry for only $199 per month. Toyota, let's go places.
Want more friends this summer? Get a new pool from The Great Escape with preseason savings up to $1,500 on all pools. Plus, up to an additional $1,500 with free installation only at The Great Escape.
Xfinity built this newer thingy that lets me search with my voice.
We're good.
Don't fall for DirecTV. Find shows faster with the X1 voice remote, only from Xfinity. Sign up today or get started with this great offer. Call or go online today.
Today on CSN Plus, the men in red are back at the pitch for an exciting Eastern Conference match with Montreal. Watch them inflame the impact and go for the goal. Coverage starts at 3:30 on CSN Plus. Feel the burn.
Today's CSN Bar of the Game, presented by Coors Light, is Timothy O'Toole's Pub. To see the complete list of the CSN Bars of the Game, presented by Coors Light, visit CSNChicago.com. Timothy O'Toole played the PCL back in the 30s. Hard-hitting Irishman, 30 lifetime average.
David Ross will get consecutive starts with John Lester pitching tomorrow. And a strike called. Scoreless here in the third. 0-1 off the outside edge.
Don't know if batting practice is predictive at all, but I was watching him swing it today. It looked awfully good in the cage.
Had a good spring and off to a good start here in the regular season. Limited chances.
And we were in Arizona. I was chatting with Mark Grace and Dave Magadan, the hitting instructors for the Diamondbacks. And Magadan said in Japan it did matter. But sometimes if they were watching BP and a guy had a really good BP, they would take somebody out of the lineup and insert that player in.
Wow. Pressure.
Puts a lot of pressure on your BP because some guys, he and Gracie got talking about Eddie Murray, you know, the Hall of Famer, and he was just a horrific BP hitter, man. He had a hard time getting the ball out of the cage.
Pretty well hit, the wind. Oh, what a catch by Gonzalez up against the padding there. I thought the wind was going to push it out of play, as it likes to do on days like this. And Cargo. Yeah. Fearless.
You see, he takes that one look at the wall. He knows what's about to hit him. It's kind of like that wide receiver running the crossing pattern, knowing he's about to get a helmet in the ribs, but he stays with it, makes the catch, takes the hit, and hangs on.
It is a great play. And it will bring up Arrieta with his third career home run on Sunday in Arizona, one of the longest we've seen. Over 440 feet. Off Shelby Miller. This one pretty well hit to right. Gonzalez with an easier play this time. Time now for our Xfinity high speed action. He got all of that one.
Yes, he did. 440, 442, something like that, I believe, is the final number.
So with two outs, it's Fowler grounded to the mound his first time up. Well, I'll tell you, if you're Walt Weiss, if Bergman gets through this third inning unscathed, you're really playing with house money. Got essentially a reliever making a start here today, and he knows he's going to have to use a lot of bullpen. Bergman hasn't even made 30 pitches yet.
Trending right now, he's going to use less bullpen than he would have anticipated. And we've talked a lot this year about the Cubs and the way they wear down starting pitchers. But that was not the case yesterday, nor is it the case today. These guys very efficient, and I think instructive too for other pitchers. I think you might as well be aggressive. If you nibble, you're going to end up putting yourself in hitters' counts. You're going to end up walking a ton of people.
Fowler leads the majors in times on base. 24 times he has reached already. On base percentage, .545. And he walks, so that OBP will go up. Cubs taking their major league leading 58th walk. Sign up for the Chicago Cubs baseball summer camps presented by ATI Physical Therapy and Ideal Industries. Young sluggers 5 to 13 will suit up in Cubs gear, meet a current Cub player during a VIP Wrigley Field visit, and get top-notch baseball instruction around the Chicagoland area. To enroll your child in the camp experience of a lifetime, it's Cubs.com /kids. A man on, two down. Cubs batting in the third. 0-2. Cardinals continue to score runs. The Reds continue to struggle with their pitching. It's 4-0 St. Louis in the bottom of the third. Brandon Finnegan on the mound today. And I believe he's given up 4 unearned runs due to a Scott Schebler error in the second. Steven Piscotty with a 3-run homer.
Man, Cardinals have scored 10 runs or more in 4 of their last 6 games. And in other baseball news, welcome to the win column, Minnesota Twins and Atlanta Braves, both starting 0-9, but they both picked up much needed W's yesterday.
Braves were down 3-0 in the 7th, came back to win on the road. Chris Sale with a 2-hit shutout in the White Sox 1-0 win at Tampa Bay last night.
He's 3-0 already.
Both Chicago teams are 8-2 to start the year. Nationals going to today, having won 6 in a row. They're 8-1. Orioles are 8-2 as well. Well, now they're making him work. Just after I said he was efficient about 11 pitches ago. On the 3-2, called strike 3, and that's the inning. So Bryant's been caught looking twice, and still nothing.
We started with the class-leading RX. We gave it paddle shifters to help you command the road. A sport mode to help you control the road. And a sport-tuned suspension to help you connect with the road. The Lexus RX F-Sport. This is the RX elevated. Lease the 2016 RX 350 for $419 a month for 36 months. See your Lexus dealer.
T-Mobile hit it out of the park. We doubled our LTE coverage to cover over 305 million Americans. And our new extended range LTE goes 2 times farther and works 4 times better in buildings than before. Switch to T-Mobile for major league coverage today.
3,000 bottles of beer on the wall, 3,000 bottles of beer. If one of those bottles happened to fall, 2,999 bottles of beer on the wall.
Tuesday night, it's time to rekindle one of baseball's fiercest rivalries as Jason Hayward and company march over the Mississippi and look to unload some firepower on the Redbirds. Cubs and Cardinals beginning at 6:30 with Cubs Pregame Live, presented by Fields Auto on CSN Plus.
Round one of the Stanley Cup playoffs shifts to Chicago as Crawford and the Hawks look to take advantage of home ice and take down the Blues. Don't miss Puck Drop tomorrow at 2 on NBC, then flip to CSN after the game for Blackhawks post-game live with Pat, Steve, and Jamal. What a good win last night.
Ooh, what
no such thing as a bad win, but
what a wild dandy third period that was. Ball one on Carlos Gonzalez. strike. 1-1. Arenado and Parra. Tough part of this order. Big games against the Cubs in his career. The end of the bat floated into left center and a base hit for an 11 game hitting streak to start the year and a 21 gamer overall. So a leadoff single, second consecutive frame in which the Rockies have had the first man on base.
It's that changeup. It's off the outside corner, but it's up. So Gonzalez able to get enough of it to flip it into left for a leadoff knock. That's down. It's likely a swing and a miss, or maybe a little rollover ground ball.
Arenado cuts and misses on a slider. Well, we're talking third baseman, an elite third baseman. So we should mention Adrian Beltre gets a 2-year extension with the Rangers. They announced that last night. He signed through 2018. Talked about Beltre during spring training. He should be an easy shoe-in for the Hall of Fame, but he doesn't probably get the due he deserves.
I would agree with that on both counts.
Four-time Gold Glover. He's in his 19th major league season. That is crushed. And boy, I thought that ball was going a lot deeper than it did. As Fowler makes a pretty easy play.
Yeah, I think the angle of attack, as Arenado had to kind of go down and get that ball, it imparted a lot of backspin.
So out number one. Maybe more off the end. Sweet spot. Here's Parra. This ball misses away. 4-1.
Last couple years, Gonzalez has not run much. Used to be a pretty legit base stealing threat.
Rockies were basically a small ball team yesterday. They stole three bases.
Not particularly quick to home plate, so stolen base numbers against him for opposing base runners. Fairly highly successful. This would be a count where Walt Weiss might want to start Cargo by a little run and hit.
Going. And it's 2-2. Weiss in his fourth season as the Rockies manager. A young general manager, Jeff Brittich. Swing and a miss, runner going. Out at second. Strike him out, throw him out. Double play, and the inning's over. Still nothing, nothing in the fourth.
At Discount Tire, we'll get you the right tire at the lowest price for your vehicle. Get a $70 Visa prepaid card when you buy any set of four Michelin tires.
Students across Colorado,
across New Jersey,
across Illinois are raising standards and achieving great things.
They're listening to teachers.
They're practicing hard
and testing their skills.
That's a game plan for success.
Go to gameplanforsuccess.org.
See schools that are knocking it out of the park.
Vote for your favorite, and we might visit them with a check for $5,000.
Learn more and vote for your favorite school at gameplanforsuccess.org.
Mom, Pa, why do we settle for cable?
Because we're settlers, and that's what we do.
But with DirecTV and AT&T, you can get your TV and wireless service from one provider.
Are not we your providers? Do we not provide you with this succulent jackrabbit pie, this delicious gray water soup, and a single lick off the family lolly every harvest moon?
Don't be a settler. Get a $100 reward card when you switch to DirecTV. Closed captioning of Cubs baseball on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you by U.S. Waterproofing.
A little seepage in your basement is no need to panic. Count on the experts at U.S. Waterproofing to diagnose and repair the problem. For a free consultation, call 888-SEEPAGE or visit seepage.com.
David Ross helping out his pitcher after Arrieta struck out Parra. Ross nailed Gonzalez.
I thought they'd have him going on the 2-1, and he wasn't. And just a perfect throw by Ross. That's a real big lead. No contact. And a great throw by Ross.
See, Russell, even though he tagged him and he was out, he kept that glove there. A lot of guys do that swipe tag. The middle infielders really, with replay now, are better off just holding the tag in case the guy comes off the bag. He's already seen. Whistle! High fly, right field, and gone! He needed that. First run driven in a while, and it's 1-0.
Snapped a long hitless streak yesterday. Now he goes deep. Got beat by a fastball last time up. This time they're going to try to go cutter in. Look at him open up that hip, drop the head, and boom. That's your Ford home run replay. It's number three for the main ingredient. What's Cargo doing out there? He's acting like he's going to camp under that one.
Jorge Soler, high, deep, left center. Go! Back to back.
That was one impressive swing of the bat right there. Second hit of the day for Soler. Solid single. Majestic home run. And barely had time to sit down after the Rizzo home run, and Soler does this. It's deja vu all over again. Ford home run replay.
First two pitches of the inning leave the yard. Bertman was terrific first time through the order. Had to make a ton of pitches to Fowler and Bryant to get out of the third. And And then boom, fourth inning. Back to back. Time the Cubs have hit consecutive home runs this year. Yeah, Rizzo's first RBI in six games. He had 10 knocked in the first five and then went into a drought. His slumps usually don't last very long. 3-2. Baez bounces foul. Struck him out. Probably was thinking three straight homers. Are you in charge of planning your next social gathering? Plan a day or evening at Wrigley Field and enjoy special perks only available inside the ballpark. The Cubs offer special ticket packages for groups of 15 or more. Visit cubs.com/groups. And as always, we remind you, if JD is going, he will gladly attend, but he will not do the planning.
Tell me when and where. See that one to the pitcher.
Busy afternoon for Gonzalez.
I'll tell you this about Bergman, those home runs haven't forced him out of the strike zone. The strike three to Baez was right over the heart of the plate. That fastball right there to Russell was pretty well channeled as well.
Well, the other thing about it, as a pitcher, you're not trying to give up home runs, but it was two pitches. And we saw in the Red Series, the walks, Caesar lines to left. But yeah, at least he's kept his pitch count in order. And as the Cubs do grab the lead, Rizzo to right. Next pitch, Soler to the bleachers in left center. 2-0.
Great things start in garages. Like the start of your perfect Honda collection with great deals during the Honda Dream Garage sales event.
Including the all-new Honda Civic. The best-selling car in its class now has a redesigned exterior.
Nice wheels. Care to upgrade?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Hey, yes, I do. Whoa.
Yeah. Hurry in. You've got a garage to fill. The Honda Dream Garage sales event has great deals on the all-new Civic. Now at your Honda dealer.
Bill Jacobs Volkswagen.
Online feedback.
A no-pressure experience from start to finish.
I was taken care of the minute I walked in.
5 stars.
Right now at Bill Jacobs Volkswagen. Lease a new 2016 Jetta S for just $99 a month. Bill Jacobs Volkswagen, home of the $99 lease.
Visit us at Bill Jacobs Volkswagen in Naperville
and online at BillJacobsVW.com.
These guys do such an incredible job, really.
Huge spring sell-off during the spring clearance event at Feeney Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Elgin. Get our lowest prices on our entire inventory. Cars, trucks, minivans, and more Jeeps than we need. All with 0% financing available. Look at this 2016 Wrangler, just $299 a month. Or a 2016 Ram 1500 Quad Cab, $299 a month. Both with zero due. Or this 2016 Dodge Caravan, only $16,997. Find it at Feeney. FeeneyAutos.com.
Sportsnet Central every night at 6:30, 10, 10:30, and midnight.
So when you have power like this in your lineup, things can happen in a hurry. Back-to-back pitches. Rizzo and then Soler go deep, and the Cubs now lead 2-0.
Arrieta back to work.
So, number three for Rizzo, number two for Soler.
Reynolds with a single. His first time up. 10th major league season. All the strikeouts, but he can hit the ball a long way.
Mm-hmm. Dangerous bat. And you've got to use as a part-time player now in a platoon situation or three, four times a week. You come off the bench and do some damage. Hit 13 home runs in a part-time role for the Cardinals last year. In the count against Arrieta, it's hard not to be thinking about the breaking pitches. And then tough to react to that heater. Reynolds probably thought this one was a little bit up, but it was good enough.
Sixth overall, first called strike three as Rayburn takes ball one. Cubs trying to even up the series after the Rockies took the opener 6-1.
Rayburn's an interesting cat. He's been around a while now, broke in with Detroit in 2004. His last four seasons, he's gone in terms of batting average, .171, then .272, .200, .301. It's like every other year, it's like he's a different guy. And a part-time player in each of those four seasons, so it's not like he's getting a lot more at-bats one year than the next. His OPS in those alternating years, .480, which is terrible, .900, which is elite, then .547 in 2014, and then bouncing back to .936 last season.
Yeah,
it's weird.
It is weird. Getting over 200 plate appearances in those seasons. Caesar over, no play this time.
So the Rockies, when they signed him, clearly not buying into the every other year program. They're just looking at what he did last year and saying, no, this is a pretty good hitter and he's going to help us.
And he had signed a minor league deal on March 4th, so not have any guarantees as he strikes out. For seven for Arrieta. Curveball.
Yeah. I like his curveball a lot today. I mean, it's always... That debate, what's Arrieta's best pitch, and from game to game it might be a different pitch, but that curveball is awfully good here today.
David Hale up in the Rockies pen. Bergman is now on deck.
Three hits for the Rockies, a couple of scratch singles, and a solid double by Garneau.
Russell will glove, throw to Rizzo, inning over. They go down 1-2-3. Cubs lead 2-0 in the fifth.
I am never getting married.
Never.
Guaranteed.
You picked a beautiful ring.
Thank you. We're never having kids.
Breathe. Pillow bit here.
We are never moving to the suburbs.
We are never getting one of those. We're never having another kid.
I'm pregnant.
I'm never letting go.
For all the nevers in life, State Farm is there.
I have a list.
Okay.
So, she needs automatic emergency braking, blind spot detection, and lane departure warning.
All available on the Elantra and Sonata.
And a better warranty than Toyota, Nissan, or Chevy.
America's best warranty, standard with every Hyundai.
Let's check in with the boss.
Okay. Sorry, excuse me.
We'll take both.
Hurry in and lease the 2016 Sonata for just $145 a month.
Just one.
Two.
She seems like a great boss.
David Keppel here with a Coors Light Cold Hard Fact SportsCenter Central update. After a drama-filled third period last night and a greasy goal from Andrew Shaw, Blackhawks return home tied 1-1 in their first-round series with the Blues. The White Sox get off to their best start in 59 years as Johnny Danks takes the bump in Tampa later this afternoon. Make sure you join Holly and me for the post-game show immediately following the final out. Now back to Wrigley. Here's Len and Big Jim.
Okay, Cap, thank you. Cubs will have Ross, Arrieta, and Fowler against Bergman. This, no doubt, will be his final inning. Pitcher spot due to lead off in the sixth. Rockies shift to the left on their infield. They play pretty much straight away in the outfield against David. And he fouls. Or strike one. Nice grab by a fan in the front row of the upper deck. Two. Got him. Five for Bergman. Mentioned he's from Southern California, La Cañada. Just north of Pasadena. Never considered a top prospect. He barely cracked the Rockies' top 30 list